frequently asked questions about human papillomavirus infection. What are the HPV types? HPV types are subdivided into two categories. Low-risk HPV types 6 and 11 cause 90-95% of genital warts. 8 higher-risk HPV types account for 95% of all cervical cancers, with just 2 of these, types 16 and 18, causing about 70%. Type 16 causes 50% of all cervical cancers, mostly squamous cell, whereas type 18 is responsible for an additional 20%, mostly adenocarcinoma. What is the peak prevalence of HPV infection? The peak prevalence of HPV infection in women occurs in their early 20s. After women reach 20 years of age, the prevalence steadily declines, although a smaller second peak occurs in postmenopausal women in some geographic areas. This may be attributed to viral persistence or perhaps new acquisition. What are the risk factors for HPV infection? Genital contact is the leading risk factor for HPV acquisition, and risk increases with the number of sex partners. Other risk factors include multiple partners, sex at an early age, failure to use condoms consistently, and a history of sexually transmitted infections. Condom use is only about 70% effective in preventing HPV transmission, because there is still contact with genital skin. Tobacco use is associated with persistent HPV infection. How is HPV transmitted? HPV is transmitted through contact with infected genital skin or mucosa. Genital warts are highly infectious because of their high viral load. Up to 65% of sexual contacts develop an infection. Oral infection with genital HPV types may occur, but the risk of transmission is less. What is the natural history of HPV infection? HPV infection may take the pathway of low viral load infection without clinical disease, or high viral load infection with clinical disease. Such disease may manifest as genital warts or as low or high grade intraepithelial lesions. Up to 90% of persons infected with high or low risk HPV clear the infection within about 2 years and the virus ceases to manifest lesions. The small minority who fail to clear the infection are at risk of progression to malignancy. What types of cancer does HPV infection lead to? Although cervical cancer is the primary concern in women with persistent HPV infection, other rarer HPV-induced cancers include those of the vagina, vulva, anus, and penis. What is the interval between infection and diagnosis of cancer? The interval between infection and diagnosis of cancer is 10 to 20 years. Because the peak incidence of cervical cancer does not occur until 40 years of age, testing for persistent HPV infection is most useful between 30 and 40 years of age. What are the different grades of intraepithelial lesions? Grade 1 cervical intraepithelial neoplasia or CIN1 indicates an active HPV infection. CIN2 is considered a high-grade lesion, but may regress spontaneously in 40% of women. CIN3 is least likely to regress and is considered a surrogate outcome, sometimes with CIN2, for cervical cancer. How is HPV detected? HPV can be detected through polymerase chain reaction testing or DNA testing. Testing for low-risk HPV types that do not cause cervical cancer has no clinical benefit. Therefore, the currently available DNA tests detect only higher-risk HPV types. Are there HPV tests for men? There are no HPV tests for use in men. Because of the risk of anal intraepithelial neoplasia and anal squamous cell cancer, anal papanicolaou or PAP testing has been proposed as a screening tool in men with human immunodeficiency virus infection and in men who have sex with men. However, anal cytology may underestimate the degree of high-grade anal intraepithelial neoplasia. Therefore, patients with abnormal findings should be referred for high-resolution anoscopy and biopsy. Is vaccination against HPV infection available? The quadrivalent recombinant HPV vaccine Gardasil protects against HPV types 6, 11, 16, and 18, and was approved for girls and women 9 to 26 years of age. It prevents genital warts and cervical cancer. The bivalent HPV vaccine Cervarix protects against types 16 and 18 only. It is approved for girls and women 10 to 25 years of age. What is the effectiveness of cervical cancer vaccines? Vaccination with a quadrivalent or bivalent HPV vaccine is 98% effective in preventing the development of high-grade precancerous cervical lesions in non-infected women. Vaccination after natural infection is less protective.
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.